A film can change your life. The film Companion, Director's Choice, is ample proof of that. Watch Dibakar Banerjee and Tigmanshu Dhulia talk about how Shekhar Kapoor's Bandit Queen changed theirs.
My introduction to Bandit Queen, I don't think you can really introduce a film, because a film kind of presents itself and disrupts your consciousness and gets into that. If you introduce a film, then it kind of changes. So I won't introduce the film. I'll tell you what I felt. It was 94.
It released in 93.
So I saw it in, 93. I was like 22. And I want to tell you not about the film, but what had happened at that time. Many of you were probably not even born in 93, man. I mean, who am I speaking? So 93 was 3 or 4 years away when the Ram drums started beating in North India, right? 88, 89. I was in school, and I remember when I used to come back from school or I used to be somewhere or whatever, I used to hear this drum, doom, 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 doom. And the Rath Yatra used to happen or something like that, and there was Ram in the air, late 80s. Then the Babri Masjid thing happened. I couldn't believe it happened. I was actually in adolescent shock. At the same time, in the late 80s, Mandal happened. And you were in DU, right?
No, I was in Delhi.
If those of you who were in Delhi at that time, I don't know, DU, Delhi University, and our streets were full of caste. Everybody was talking about caste. Everybody was talking about communities. Everybody was talking about OBC, EAB, CBC, whatever the hell it is. And suddenly, everything that I had read in my history book or civics books or social studies textbooks was proven as a lie right in front of my eyes. I was told Bharat ek vishal desh hai. Bharat ka dharm ahimsa hai. भारत में सब धर्म सब जात सब पात सब कम्युनिटी साथ साथ अहिंसा में रहते हैं. दिस वॉज द ब्रॉड नैरेटिव ऑफ हिस्ट्री दैट हैड बीन टोल्ड टू मी. आई डोंट नो व्हाट यू रेड, बट दैट्स व्हाट आई हैड रेड. नॉट दैट आई बिलीव्ड इन इट टू मच, बट देन आई डिडंट बिलीव एनीथिंग, बट स्टिल इट वॉज देयर इन माई कॉन्शियसनेस. बट वॉट आई स्टार्टेड सीइंग द मोमेंट आई स्टार्टेड बींग एन अडल्ट 18, 19, फ्रॉम दैट टू अबाउट 25, एवरीथिंग दैट आई सॉ was in direct contrast to everything that I read. Nor were we non-violent, nor were we caste imperative, nor were we religiously tolerant, nor were we communally tolerant. We were just not tolerant, and we were becoming more and more violent. And then I was there when Ram Janmabhoomi happened, and I was there when Mandal happened, and I was there in front of my eyes when the Bombay riots happened. I've taken a local train right from, on a local train where, you know, both sides, the city's on fire. I was there in every riot somehow. I don't know what happened to me. I mean, every riot I used to be in that city. So I saw that time. And I was an extremely confused person. I didn't know, kya ye jo padhta hoon, ye dikhta kyun nahi hai mere ko aankhon ke samne. And then I started traveling a bit as a student. And then, Tigmanshu, I went to a place called Orai. Mm-hmm. Orai is a small town in the border of Madhya Pradesh and UP. So I went there and I stayed in that small town for about 15 days because my friends wanted to show me small town in Heartland India. And I had never been to Heartland India before that. I was 25, 24, whatever it was. And that was the time when I saw what India, a large part of India, is. Just how violent it can be, just how patriarchal it can be, just how misogynist it can be, just how casteist it can be, just how communal it can be, at every level of our existence. And I couldn't reconcile that to my existence as an Indian who was reading some textbooks which had no connection with the real Indian experience. Then came Bandit Queen. Till that time, I was seeing Indian films, and somehow the Indian films had passed me by. But whatever I heard, I mean, I could see colorful costumes, high-waisted jeans, a certain kind of music, a certain kind of setup, Bombay Mafia, ye wo sab kuch dekh raha hu. But nothing connected to what I saw in front of my eyes. Bandit Queen came and it connected at last that what I'm seeing on the screen here is, I can imagine, is about 3 hours or 4 hours ride away from Delhi in a village somewhere. Bandit Queen to me was the first cinematic experience that showed India the way it is, the way it really is, the way it was in the 70s, the way it was in the 80s, the way it was in the 90s, and now. And that's why I want you to see it. I want you to see this film, because India still is like this. We live in a microscopic bubble. We think this is our India, but there's a large part of India which is extremely violent. And as we speak right now, there's a lot of violence being committed. There's a lot of repression being committed against a woman, or a man or a woman from a lower caste, or a certain person from a certain religion. And he's being repressed not only by another community or another sex or another caste or another religion. There is also a systematic repression which has come ingrained in the way India is being governed. That's what I sincerely believe. And when you see this film, you will see that. When you see this film, and when you come to the end, the only time when we skip out of the world of Phoolan Devi and come to the world that we know, we are in the world of the bureaucrats. And there you will see a scene which says, whoever said shooting, have you ever heard of surrender?
One stupid low-caste woman in a godforsaken place I can't even find on the map is threatening to bring down our state government. You know how strong is Thakur's lobby in our state?
We are doing our best, sir. She will be dead soon.
Dead? Whoever said anything about killing? You know the kind of following she has amongst lower castes. They to vote, you know.
So, what are my orders, sir?
Have you heard of something called surrender?
And there you will see how we are a part of that repressive system as well. So that's what I want you to see. I know it's a harrowing beginning to a film. Yaar, film dekhne aaya to kuch ash karenge. I mean, it's a very entertaining film, actually. I find it very entertaining. I find it a very, very fantastic watch. I can watch it again and again and again, but that's probably because I'm a man. My wife, who I saw it with 20 years ago, she still can't see it. And she loved it. So it's a film which polarizes people. It's a film that you want to watch and you don't want to watch. And I would like you to see it, because I would like you to know that this is our India still, and you live in that country, and you're a part of the system which is being depicted. And over to Tigmangshu. I just have one thing to say. In Delhi, when we were there in the mid-90s, when we were sort of, you know, I was making ad films and all that, there were a lot of actors who had met you and Shekhar, and their best memories are about the casting process and how NSD and all those people were kind of overjoyed to work in a film like this. In fact, Gajraj, yeah, at that time was a friend of ours, because he was working on something with us, and he told me about how you guys worked on the casting, and how Shekhar kind of told him not to inhibit himself when he, in that scene where he tries to molest Phoolan Devi.
Oh dear. Talk about the time.
yaar, sabki zindagi mein no, kuch moments hote hain. सबकी ज़िंदगी में, मेरी, आपकी. वी आर बॉर्न, वी पास द 10th ग्रेड, वी पास द 12th ग्रेड, वी गेट आर फर्स्ट पे चेक, वी फॉल इन लव. ये सब, ये पड़ाव सबकी ज़िंदगी में होते हैं. बैंडिट क्वीन वॉज वन सच थिंग इन ऑल आर लाइव्स हू वर कनेक्टेड विद बैंडिट क्वीन. इट कम्प्लीटली चेंज्ड आर लाइव्स. एंड आई वॉज फॉर्चुनेट इनफ दैट आई एम स्टेइंग इन दिल्ली एट दैट टाइम. नॉट मेनी फिल्म्स यूज्ड टू हैपन आउट ऑफ दिल्ली, बट soon as I passed out from drama school in 89, I continued to do films there, one after the other. And Bandit Queen, after Bandit Queen, I came to Bombay. The interesting thing about Bandit Queen was, when Shekhar ji came to direct it, well, the film happened out of Delhi. The producer, Mr. Bobby Bedi, was from Delhi, and Shekhar was selected and invited by Farooq Dhondi to direct this picture. And I remember him coming to Delhi, and he had these photographs And the state Shekhar ji was in, I think that's the best state stage to enter a film. You're not sure what you're going to do. You should never be sure, I think. And that's what I've learned from Shekhar ji. Be spontaneous like an actor, like an animal, and then enter the arena of direction. So when he came to Delhi, he had this photograph, and I won't mention names. Sabne red bandana bana ke photograph khich ke bheje the Shekhar ji ke saath. Bahut si aadmi dhoondunga ki mil jayenge mujhko. And main leak karunga fir unko. So Shekhar ji us state se aaye the ki yehi actors hain aur kuch mein se kuch the jo unko dimag mein tha ki jo Phoolan Devi ka revenge hai isme. Us revenge ka motivation Shekhar ji chahte the strong, that is why that nude walk in the film. So he was sure that he will do that. तो वो ऐसी हीरोइंस हु वर स्लाइटली मोर बोल्ड शेखर जी हम करें वो सब ने रेड बैंडाना बांध के फोटोग्राफ भेजी थी. तो हमने देखा, मैंने कहा सर ये थोड़ा सा मैं आपको थोड़ा बताता हूँ कि अब शेखर जी ने वो दुनिया नहीं देखी थी. शेखर जी ने कभी उन एक्टर्स के साथ काम नहीं किया था जो बैंडिट क्वीन में है. मेरे पास एक ग्रीन वेस्पा स्कूटर होती थी. मैंने कहा शेखर जी बैठो पीछे आप मेरे, और लेकिन मैं मंडी हाउस में रेपर्टरी कंपनी है, थिएटर वेटर दिखा रहा हूँ. तो रंजीत कपूर साहब का प्ले था खूबसूरत बहू, सीमा उसमें एक्टिंग कर रही थी. तो मैं शेखर जी को मैंने कहा ये देखिए बैंडिट क्वीन ये है आपकी. तो उन्होंने ऑडिशन किया, बहुत तरह तरह के बहुत ही इंटेंस ऑडिशन हुए. इवेंचुअली शेखर जी को धीरे धीरे समझ में आया, देन स्लोली ही गॉट इनटू दैट दुनिया दैट वर्ल्ड. और इतनी रियल फिल्म हिंदी सिनेमा में
शायद आफ्टर मिस्टर इंडिया
एंड आफ्टर या आफ्टर मिस्टर इंडिया.
आई मीन मासूम, मिस्टर इंडिया, बैंडिट क्वीन. I mean, that's a testament to the man and the risks he takes.
Yeah, yeah. So versatile he was. So Bandit Queen ka was great experience. Uske baad hua Bandit Queen ka Delhi se major exodus ho gaya. Sare actors jo hain Delhi chhod ke Bombay aa gaye. Wo chote chote actors jo Bhopal, Gwalior se maine casting kare the, sab ne maa pitaji ka pair chhua aur sab Bombay aa gaye. To ye bahut bahut badi galti hui Bandit Queen. Main kochta hu ki aisa nahi hona chahiye tha. बेचारों को लगा कि हम स्टार बन जाएंगे. बड़े स्ट्रगल आज भी मैं मिलता हूँ उनसे, तो मुझको लगता है कि यार क्यों हुआ. अब किसी के साथ अच्छा हुआ, किसी के साथ बुरा हुआ,
उसका आंसर तो अनु कपूर ने दे दिया है ना. फिल्म फेयर लेते वक्त अनु कपूर ने कहा था कि भगवान मुझे अगले जन्म में टैलेंटेड मत पैदा करना, खूबसूरत पैदा करना.
नहीं, अनु कपूर से मैं अब ज्यादा वक्त नहीं लूंगा. मुझे शेखर जी ने अनु कपूर को भी कास्ट किया था बैंडिट क्वीन में, वो रोल मैंने किया. अच्छा, अनु कपूर साहब बिकॉज मिस्टर इंडिया कर चुके हैं, बहुत अच्छे एक्टर हैं वो. तो जब बैंडिट क्वीन शूटिंग चल रही थी तो तुगलकाबाद फोर्ट रोड में, तो अनु कपूर साहब भी एक ऐसे लग रहे थे जो बाकी जो टीम थी, जो सेट ऑफ एक्टर्स थे उनके साथ वो थोड़ा जेल नहीं कर पा रहे थे. नेचुरली स्टार है, बॉम्बे से आए थे, अपना वो 555 पी रहे थे, यहाँ पे बीड़ी पीने के पैसे नहीं. तो वो तो शेखर जी इस बात को समझ गए, ताड़ गए. पट से पहले ही दिन दो शॉट दिए होंगे उन्होंने अनु कपूर से खुद में बात की, और अनु कपूर वो प्यार से किया, शायद मुझसे गलती हुई है ये वो. और अनु कपूर साहब दूसरी फ्लाइट पकड़ के उनको बॉम्बे भेज दिया. कोई इंसल्टिंग नहीं, कोई ह्यूमिलेशन नहीं हुआ, कुछ नहीं. बट शेखर जी ने समझ गया कि यार इन एक्टर्स के साथ इतने दिन शूटिंग करनी है तो शायद अनु कपूर साहब ठीक होगा नहीं इनके साथ बाकी हुआ. तो उस तरह की इंसाइट थी बच्चों के साथ. जो आप पहला शॉट देखोगे फूलन देवी का, फर्स्ट शॉट छोटी सी बच्ची, क्या परफॉर्मेंस निकलवाना, ये सब शेखर जी सीखा. तो बहुत फॉर्चुनेट हूँ मैं कि मैं बैंडेड क्वीन का हिस्सा हूँ. एक छोटा सा और एक वाक्य सुनाऊंगा, उसके बाद भगवान से चलूंगा कि इसमें एक न्यूड वॉक है, आप देखना कि अब शेखर जी चाहते थे वो न्यूड वॉक. अब रिवेंज का मोटिवेशन स्ट्रांग, रिवेंज का मोटिवेशन स्ट्रांग, तो न्यूड वॉक तो कैसे करें न्यूड वॉक. उन्होंने कहा तब तो VFX होते नहीं थे, उन्होंने कहा वो पूरे सब लोग गाँव वाले देखेंगे और फूलन देवी वो नंगा जो है वो वॉक करेगी वेल कुएँ के पास. अब वो चंबल है वहाँ पे, कहेगा सर नंग मतलब बिना कपड़े के लड़की गोली चल जाएगी यहाँ पे, उसको उठा लेंगे कोई ना कोई. क्या नहीं करना है, करना है. तो हमने एक शेड्यूल करके वापस आए, फिर तैयारी करके दोबारा से शेड्यूल करने गए. तो ये था सब तैयार थे कि शॉट लेंगे, दो कैमरा थे, शॉट लेंगे, गाड़ी में बैठा पोलो वापस. लेकिन अब शूटिंग तो होती है, अरे एक टेक और सब होता है वो. लेकिन गांव वाले हिले नहीं, कोई सीन है ना, कोई कैट कॉज ना कोई कुछ, कोई प्रॉब्लम ही नहीं हुई. मैंने कहा क्या हो रहा है ये. उसके बाद चले गए, मैंने पूछा, कहते साहब झूठा तो था. मैंने कहा क्या झूठा था, कहते साहब झूठा था वो प्लास्टिक लगाया हुआ था. क्योंकि वो शूटिंग दे चुके थे किस तरह से वो कॉन्डोम में ब्लड डाल के बुलेट इफेक्ट्स होते हैं क्या होते हैं उनको पता उनको लगा सब नकली है तो बेचारों ने कुछ नहीं किया तो ये मैजिक है सिनेमा का थैंक यू वेरी मच
सब्सक्राइब टू फिल्म कंपेनियन ऑन यूट्यूब टू गेट योर फिल्म फिक्स